Hi, welcome to one more video on memories. So let us continue with the RAM memories. So in the last two videos we have seen, okay, how do we realize SRAM bit. So we have seen that SRAM can be implemented using 6 transistors, and we have to have proper dimensions of different transistor to be fixed so that there is no problem in either reading or writing the bit values. And we have also seen that we can able to still get this SRAM implemented with using only 4 transistors, so that is replacing 2 transistor by high value of resistance. The next category of random access memory is DRAM, that is dynamic RAM. So D stands for your dynamic. So as the name itself indicates, in your SRAM we had the value of the bit will be stored in that particular bit for as long as the power supply is on. So no need to refresh the value. So as long as the supply is on, so we're going to have the stored value in that particular bit. It will be statically stored because it is there in a feedback loop of back-to-back transistor. So that value will be kept as the desired stored value will be kept as it is. So next category is DRAM. So DRAM is nothing but dynamic RAM. In this dynamic RAM, it is slightly different from the static. Now there is no question of holding the value for long time. So let us try to understand how do we realize this DRAM in using the transistors. So this is how a DRAM looks like. This is one transistor. So let us consider a NMOS transistor. This is the second transistor, which is now grounded here. And let me have a third transistor, which is connected over here. Let me name it as M1. This is M2. This is M3. Now you can see I have bit lines BL1. Let me have one more bit line BL2. So let me have 2 word lines. So let me consider 1 word line here and 1 more word line. So let us of course, in the previous case of SRAM we had only word line for both reading as well as writing. So now let me just consider this is connected here and this is now connected to this. You can see it's connected to different word lines. So this is 1 word line, this is the second word line. So depending on the operation that is performed by these word lines, so they will be set as write word line or read word line. So as we can see from this, so this word line is used to write the value onto this dynamic memory. That's why I'll call this as write word line. So this will understand the working of this DRAM. Let me now say this as DRAM. So this particular line will be used to write the value of the bit to be stored, will be used using this word line, and the second word line will be used to read the value that is stored here. So that's why I'll call this as read word line. So depending on the function, we call it as either write word line or read word line. So let us try to understand the working of this particular DRAM. So let us first understand, okay, how do I write the value. So for writing the value, whatever value you want to write it onto this particular bit, assume that you want to write a high, or you want to store the logic 1 need to be stored here. In such case, if at all if you want to store a logic 1, what you have to store is, suppose if you want to read a logic 1, meaning if you want to store a value of 1 here, suppose if this DRAM has to hold a value of 1, means you have to actually store a 0, the opposite value. Suppose upon reading, if you want to get a high value, what you have to store is a low value. So let us try to understand, okay, why we are supposed to store a opposite value than what is to be read. So now the intention is I have to read a high value. I have to read a high value. In order to read a high value, what I will be writing is I will write a low value should be written. So low value should be written. Let us see, okay, why a low value is written. You can see, in order to write a low value onto this, so now you can see this BL1. BL1 is made equal to low. So BL1 is made equal to low. You can see there is a capacitor here. There is a parasitic capacitor. This is not a lumped one. I'm representing this CS, that is storage capacitor, which happens to be the drain and bulk capacitance and gate and source capacitance. So these two capacitances will come in parallel and they're going to add up, and we say it as storage capacitance CS. Suppose whenever you make this BL is equal to zero, whenever you make, of course, have your BL is equal to zero, and then make right word line as high. Whenever I make this right word line as high and this as low, whatever value that is stored in this CS, if at all if some value is stored here, will be fully discharged, will be get fully discharged, so that you will going to have a low will be stored here, meaning so this will be fully discharged. This CS will actually hold zero charges, meaning since BL1 is made low and your M1 transistor is turned on because of your WWLS, that is right word line is equal to 1, whatever charges that is there will be get discharged. Okay, after some time you will have CS, the voltage at CS will be equal to 0 volt. So now we are having a 0 volt stored here. So now let us see how do I read this value, because what was the intention? The intention was to read a high value. So since a value of 0 is stored here, during the read operation, what I'll do is I will make this RWL as equal to high. This RWL, because this is read word line, is made high, which will make your M3 transistor to turn on. Of course, before I make this high, I have to make my bit line 2 as pre-charge. So this is pre-charge to VDD. So this, because we know that even in case of SRAM, before you start any read operation, you are making BL and BL bars as VDDs. On the same lines, if at all if you want to read what is the value that is stored in this DRAM, we will make, in this case, only bit line 2 is made equal to. So this is bit line 2 is pre-charged to VDD. Then you make this RWL as equal to high. That will turn on your transistor. Now, depending on the charge that is stored in this transistor, M2 is either on or off. Since we have actually stored a low here, the M2 is off. Since M2 is off, Even though this transistor is on, the pre-charge voltage that is at BL, the pre-charge voltage at BL will remain as pre-charge value. Meaning, since the stored value is zero here, this transistor is off because this is not enough. This doesn't have enough voltage to turn on this M2. Even though M3 is on, there is no path for this pre-charge voltage to discharge. So this BL2 will hold the value of VDD. So when you actually read it, BL2 is read as VDD. So what did you actually store? You actually store an opposite value that needs to be read, because the intention was reading high value. Are we reading high now? Yes, we are reading a high value. If at all if you want to read a low value, let me just write the complement of that. If I want to read a low value, you have to actually store the opposite of it. So what are the opposite of low? So you have to store a high value. So what you have to do, this bit line one, you make it high. When you make your bit line as high, again make this W right word line should be made high, then voltage across capacitor will go to almost close to VDD, to be very precise VDD minus VTH, because this is a pass transistor, the voltage at this point will be lesser than this voltage by point or the VTH value. So now this CS is the voltage at across this capacitor is VDD. Now we can see this is holding a value of VDD, this is holding a value of VDD. So now if you want to read the value, what is there? So as we did here, pre-charge this to VDD, it has been pre-charged. You make this high because you are actually reading the word line, because read word line is made 1. When this is 1, M3 is on, M2 is also on. In the previous case, M2 was off. Now in this case, M2 is on, M3 is also on, because you made this RWL is equal to high. Why this is on? Because your voltage across capacitor is also high. So when these two are high, whatever charge that you have in the form of pre-charged value on your BL2 will fully discharge. When it fully discharges, after some time, you can see this will be holding a low value. So because you have stored an opposite value of high, that has resulted in reading a value of low here. So in case of DRAM, the main disadvantage is, assume that you want to read a value of 1. Assume that you want to read a value of 0. We know that if you want to read a value of 0, I need to store a VDD here. So this has been made VDD, and then you have made the right word line as 1. The VDD has stored here. Assume that you are not reading anymore. If you're not reading immediately, so what happens is, this is a capacitor, parasitic capacitor, which is holding the charge, may start losing the charge because of leakages. Because of leakages on either side, the voltage across this VCS, voltage across this storage capacitor may come down. When it comes down, at the time when you are reading the value, if the voltage of this is less than the threshold voltage of this, so you'll be actually reading a different value. So you are supposed to make this turn on. If it has fully discharged, so the voltage across this may not be able to turn on. What you thought was, you have stored a high value, because of leakage it has totally discharged to almost less than VTH. When you actually read the value by making this RW as high, you are actually still getting it as high, because this is not on, because it has fully discharged. So you will end up with an erroneous reading. So to avoid such type of issues in DRAM, what they will do is, they very often recharge whatever that is stored here. Assume that you have stored 1 here. If you have stored one here, even though you are not reading this, you keep on still rewriting this. Because if you don't rewrite, what happens is, you're going to lose the charge. If you lose the charge, then you'll end up with an erroneous reading. So to avoid that, so this particular capacitor will be always recharged time and again, so that this doesn't lose the value that need to be stored. So that is the main disadvantage of this DRAM. So DRAM always requires repeated writing onto this. So typically what happens is, before you read anything, you write it once and then read. If you are not at all reading, just keep repeatedly writing the value whatever you want to store. Again, let me just repeat. If at all, if you want to read a value of high, you have to store a low here. If at all, if you want to read a value of low, you have to write a value of high. So let us try to understand using waveforms. So how do I make this DRAM? Okay, let me just rewrite the DRAM structure and then try to identify how the waveforms looks like. So I have bit line 1. This is my pass transistor. which is connected to now this is the one which is used to write. Let me connect it. Write word line, and I have one read word line. So before that, this will go to a transistor, and I have one more pass transistor which is connected to PL2. Now this is for reading the value, this is for writing the value. Now you can see this has gone up here. So this is for read word line. So let us try to, let me say this as M1, M2, M3. So let us try to understand. As I said, first I need to have write word line. Whenever your write word line goes high, let me write BL1. If your BL1, of course, let me make your BL1 stable before my write word line becomes 1. You can see. So whenever this is high, it sees what is the value of this. Since it is 1, okay, let me just make this to go down here. Since it is 1, so suppose if I write a potential X here. So let me write what is Vx is. Vx will be, assume that it is, if it is initially 0, if it is at 0 volt. So if you are considering this as VDD, this also as VDD, this will turn on to a voltage equal to VDD minus VTH. Now the voltage across the capacitor will be, suppose if this is equal to VDD, whenever you make your word line, write word line as high, this will store a voltage which is less by the threshold voltage of this M1 transistor. Now you can see it is retaining. Suppose if you don't write it again, there is a possibility that it may just go down. So it may just go to 0 volt. So now this is done. Now it has been stored. Now what is stored? You have actually stored a 1 here. Now let me do this read operation. So I want to read it now. It is now read word line is made high now. So you can see, before I do any read operation, I'm actually writing it. Now you can see, let me just still make this stable here. Let me make the bit line is still made. So now, since I want to read the value from your this one, let me make BL2 as precharged. So let me just make it equal to VDD. Now it is precharged. Can see now it is precharged till you turn on this transistor, because even when you make this let me just make this BL2 slightly high. You can see maybe you can just make this 0 before you make your read line. You make this to go high. Now you can see you precharged it. So this is precharged to VDD. So whenever you precharge this to VDD, so what happens? Okay, now this has been precharged. So once your read line goes high, you can see the voltage at this point Vx is high. So this voltage, which is equal to VDD here, will start going down. You can see once this goes high, this will not remain as high. This will start coming down. You can see this started coming down. So why this has started coming down is because this transistor is on, because VDD minus VTH is the voltage at this point. This is on. This is also on here. You can see this is also on. So now once this goes off, the voltage at this point or whatever that will just stay there. Now since this M2 transistor is on, this started reducing, meaning the bitline voltage has started dissipating the value from the precharged value of VDD. So it was precharged to VDD before your read word line comes. So you can see before this read word line goes high, it has been precharged. So after that, whenever your read word line goes high, the charge started coming down. You can see it is going down and then it stays. Now, to decide whether the value that is stored here is because I want to read a value of because you have stored a value of high, you'll be reading a low value. But you can see here, within this time, the voltage might have not yet reached zero. Because this is the only small amount of time you have, this may not be sufficient to lose the voltage from maybe 1.8 volt to 0 volt. So assume that it has slightly discharged. So what happens here in case of reading operation is, there is a sense amplifier that will be connected. So there is a sense amplifier that will be connected. It's like a differential amplifier. So what you're looking at is, so at this plus and minus, you connect around, assume that this is equal to 1.8 volt. Assume that you're connected around 1.3 volt here, and this is connected your bit line 2. So bit line 2 was, of course, what you can do is either you can make this negative, make this positive. Of course, this can be made reverse. Now you can see here, now bit line is made, this is connected to bit line and this is connected to 1.3 volt. So before the starting of your, suppose if I say this has Y output, let me also trace what is the Y output here. So this is Y output, you just forget about what is the value here. You come down here, so what is the value of BL2 here? BL2 is high, BL2 is high here. So this is 1.3. when I say high means it is more than 1.3. are you getting negative now? You're actually getting negative. So even though this may not be totally going to zero, so what happens whenever this voltage goes less than 1.3, whenever this voltage goes less than 1.3, so then does this go to high? Now you can see this is actually saying whatever value that you are stored is actually representation of high, the representation of high value. Because in this particular case, you are stored high, you are reading high because of this inversion that is happening. Instead of connecting this as minus plus, suppose if you connect this as plus and minus, suppose if you connect 1.3 volt here and if you are connecting BL2 here, what will happen initially there is Y output will be initially high, then it goes down to low. The point here is that of course, depending on the sense amplifier configuration what you have, the bit line voltage will be represented at this Y point. The whole intention of doing this dynamic RAM is you can implement one bit of memory using only three transistors. Using only three transistor itself, I can able to represent a bit. But only issue with this type of DRAM is that you are supposed to repeatedly write the value, otherwise the value will be lost here. So assume that if you are keeping it as it is, what happens, this bit line, so this is the value of Vx which is there here. So it may so happen that if this is zero, it may so happen that it may just discharge to zero. So if you want to avoid this, what will do is, so there is a repeated writing done. When the writing is repeated, so at the time of writing, whatever charges that you have lost, you can able to recover back. Make it equal to Vd minus Vth. So this repeated writing will help the DRAM to store the value that was actually asked to keep it over there. So this way we can able to read the value from a DRAM. Again, don't be get confused. So it was earlier said that if you want to read a value on this bit line as bit line 2 as high, you have to actually store a low value. If at all, if you want to read a low value here, you have to store a high value. Of course, this sense amplifier is one, because you cannot wait until this voltage goes to zero. VD. So whenever there is a trend of going down, whenever there's a trend from VDD to going down, you can say that the stored value is low. Whenever there's a trend of going from, okay, whenever there's a trend that, okay, output voltage, the pre-charge voltage is VDD, and if it is not at all changing, means then you can say that it is, the stored value is, or the represented value is actually VDD. The bit line we're going to read it as VDD. So sometimes it is also possible that, so you pre-charge with, so here we said that, okay, PL2 is pre-charged with VDD, pre-charged with VDD. In some other cases, what happens is they will pre-charge with half of the VDD. So they'll just pre-charge with half of the VDD. Suppose if this half of the VDD discharges, this goes down. If this half of VDD is not allowed to discharge, suppose if this charges, then this goes above. You can see there are two possibilities. You may can lose the voltage that is there in your pre-charge bit line, or you can gain. If you are losing, means you are actually discharging. If you are gaining, means you are getting the charges. So if you are getting the charges, means the value that is stored, the bit line is 1. If you are losing the charge, means the bit line is 0. The bit line is 0. So by just having a look at the sense amplifier trend, whether it is increasing or decreasing, I can say that whether the stored value will represent a logic 0 or logic 1. So this way we never wait until the capacitor to, or the whatever pre-charge value to discharge. So you just see the trend. If it increases, then we immediately say that, okay, the red value is high. If it start reducing from the pre-charge value, then you can say it as it is going towards, or the stored value is actually 0.